Will Google delete inactive accounts? Now the answer is now yes. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not subscribed to my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing, visit askleo.com/newsletter and sign up now. You'll get weekly tips, tricks, answers, and heads up like this one every week on Tuesdays. So, Google recently announced that they are going to start closing, deleting inactive accounts. What does that mean? Well, as it turns out, the guidelines are pretty simple. If the account hasn't been used in any way for 2 years or longer, then they may delete it. They're going to start at the end of this year, 2023. But the bottom line is that an account that hasn't been accessed in over 2 years is at risk. Now, originally, they included YouTube videos in that. In other words, any YouTube videos that were associated with your Google account would also be deleted. They've since pulled back on that, basically due to, I suspect, public outcry, because there's a lot of information, a lot of valuable stuff out on YouTube that we don't want to see go away. But for everything else, your email, your Google Drive, your Google Photos, your anything and everything associated with your Google account, if you haven't used it in 2 years, that information is at risk of being deleted permanently and without any hope of recovery. So, what does that mean you need to do? Well, sign into your account. Just do something. Log in, send an email, use Google Drive, watch a YouTube video, download something from the Play Store, anything, literally anything that causes you to authenticate that account and sign in using that account is enough to reset the clock. That's really all it takes. Now, there are some very legitimate concerns about what I'll refer to as collateral damage, even without the YouTube videos. And that is simply that, what if you don't have access to the account? What if it's the account of, say, a deceased friend or relative? The information that has been posted publicly remains, even though they are no longer around to access their account. That's going to go away. The only thing that you and I have in a situation like that is to use whatever techniques we can come up with to download copies of that information. That may be something that Internet Archive is trying to do, but nonetheless, it is something that you might want to be aware of if you are relying on content from folks who no longer have access to their accounts remaining online. It might not. And I have to stress that even though YouTube is currently not included in this, it could be. At some future date, it is extremely possible that, yes, they could extend this to YouTube videos as well. And to be even more paranoid, yes, this is an announcement from Google this week, but it could be any provider. Any place you have information uploaded could go away in an instant and could easily say that, you know, you haven't used your account for a while. We're going to assume you've abandoned it and no longer need to have your information online. We're going to free up space, cut our costs, do whatever by removing that information from the internet. If that's not something you want to see happen, then either sign into your account regularly, potentially make sure to keep copies of everything you've uploaded somewhere else. And if it's for an account you don't have access to, download what you can using whatever techniques you have available, depending on what it is. Now, there is one open question here, and that is also an important one. If you delete an account, a Gmail account, there's an email address associated with that. I'll just say example@gmail.com. When that account gets deleted, does that mean that that email address is then made available for someone else to reuse? We don't know. Nothing was said on that. It is an open issue whenever accounts are deleted. Usernames or account email addresses for email accounts can sometimes simply go back into the available pool so that someone can come along later and say, hey, Let's see if example@gmail.com is available. And sure enough, because it just got deleted for being inactive for 2 years, it is now available. We don't know. You run the risk of that being a possibility, but right now there is no answer to that. The one thing I do want to point out about that scenario is that even if they make email addresses reusable after they've been closed for being inactive, creating an account with that email address will not give access to or restore any of the data that was part of that account's previous existence. So if you've got a ton of data with example@gmail.com and you allow that account to go inactive and Gmail decides or Google decides to delete that account because you've abandoned it, then if someday later somebody is allowed to create example@gmail.com, that account will be empty. Your old data will not be there. But that's the scenario. Heads up, if you've got stuff online you want to see preserved, it's on you to preserve it. And Gmail has just given you a warning to log into your account at least every 2 years. I hope that's helpful. I hope that gives you something to think about and hopefully something to do. For updates, comments, and related information, visit askleo.com/157080. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.